I try to all my life to bring smarter people than myself to the company. And the challenge is, you know, how to keep them in the company. Very easy. You tell me what we are doing wrong and what can I do better, and you have a very good chance to, you know, work with Studio Moderna.
So have you heard?
That's a very small secret. Yeah, I'm telling, you know, the companies, if they want to work with us, then, you know, they have to do some mystery shopping and show how we can solve our pains that we have, and that's all. You know, just to let you know, we started a company with no vision. There was no big, great vision. Actually, I had started one of the first computer companies in Slovenia in late 80s. And when a friend of mine introduced me to Cosmodisk, I joked about the device. I didn't believe that this could work. But I didn't want to be arrogant, so I tested it. And when my friends told me that it really worked, then I was still skeptical. So I asked my wife to manage the company, you know. So I didn't even join the company, Studio Moderna, at the beginning. I was still director of the computer company. And then I realized that my wife is growing her company faster, you know, than I did my computer company. And I wrote the application.
You took it back?
No, then I wrote an application, you know, to join the smarters, the winners.
And today, do you sleep well?
I sleep on Dormeo, so I sleep well. So what you have to do is, you have to bring the best talents, and this is my passion. And my main investment was always only intangible assets, and this is today the main strength of Studio Moderna. So bringing the smartest people that you have. But then you have also to accept, you know, to deal with them, that you're not always the smarter. And this is, you know, not easy many times. And people think that this will jeopardize your image, your position in the company, the opposite. You know, when, let's say, intern tells you, I say, I like this product, and she's, let's say, doing a media planning in the company, and she tells me, yeah, but I doubt that this product will really work, but said, push it a little bit more, you know, put some more media power behind, and maybe it'll work. And she tells me, she's, let's say, 25, young, and we have management meeting, and she's explaining the return on investment on every product. And she's telling me, yeah, Sandy, just you have to tell me how much you love this product, and I will calculate you how much money you're going to lose. So I said, okay, forget it. So this is the way, you know, and I think that really, I invest in three things, in my life. In talents, so I'm always hunting for talents wherever I am, whether I'm in a restaurant, wherever I'm sitting, I'm looking for talents. And I bring them, try to attract them and to bring them to the company, even if I don't have concrete position for them, because we are growing that very fast, and there is always some need for new talents. Then technology. Microsoft knows this very well. We invest a lot on technology, and today even I'm proud that we can advise, that we are sitting in advisory board of Microsoft with 40 companies around the world, sharing our experiences with them. And the third thing is in innovations, so no tangibles. And that's it. It's very simple, actually, everything. You have to use the, in this turbulent situations, you have to use the farmer's logic, and this helps. And maybe just one more about talking about the talents. I would recommend you several, what we do a lot, but not because here is American ambassador, but what I would say is, what I learned a lot is learning things about American army, you know, and they're very interesting things. And about 10, 15 years ago, it was one of the most popular books among American managers, was a manual for American Marines, written by an officer. I think it's called War Fighting. Very tiny book. And you know what? There are two key elements there that are essential assets of the in the army. they're not talking about the arms, they're not talking about the, you know, guns and this. It's trust and professionalism. So you have to be, you know, in team, you have to have professionals that they can deliver, and you have to have trust among them. And my role is, you know, among all these talented people and key stakeholders, who are also many times, you know, huge egos, you know, how to keep a happy family and inspire them to work and to do the best for the company. Well, we don't plan to expand to the moon yet, but our main markets are in Eastern Europe, where we have developed our own distribution infrastructure. But you know, I'm glad to have challenges like selling mattresses produced in Italy to Berlusconi's TV station. I'm glad that we are expanding them that we are selling them in Japan to the company that our importer is company that, let's say, has turnover of $120 billion. That we are a very big player now becoming in UK, and the next step is United States, and after that we'll see. Always you fear, I mean, that's healthy, you know, that keeps you going and thinking and everything, you know, when walking on the edge, which I like to do, because it's not a crowded place, you know. That's always fear, yeah. And that's good for adrenaline. You know, I think that all what we are seeing now around us, it's not the result of the financial crisis. You know, financial crisis and the banks and this was some kind, as I see it, some accelerator. But, you know, you can read in the books that were, you know, published 15 years ago. One very interesting is blur. And what we are seeing today, it's a blur. You know, saying very simple things, you know. Economy is the way how people use resources to fulfill their desires. And, you know, these things have shifted many times in the history, several times. And today we are again seeing and facing this kind of tremendous shifts. The shift where things that are driving the shift are not anymore so much tangible elements, but much more intangible, you know, the speed, connectivity, relationship, and this is what we don't see. You know, so people are waiting maybe too much that the old good days would come back, that things would become again predictable, and we have to learn, you know, how to dance in this world of blur, how to behave in this, because I believe that, you know, this fog which is around us will stay for some time, because we are in the transition in which things are changing, the speed is constantly accelerating, and things are changing so fast that we cannot put them in the proper focus, you know, as we used to do.
Sure.
So we have to live with this, and we have to take advantage of this, and this is what we are doing. And this is where also opportunity of a small country and a small economy is. Because today everybody is in pain, and you just need to provide, you know, the solutions for the pains that are around.